School districts across the country are refocusing their efforts on campus security following the mass shooting at Marjory Stoneman Douglass High School in Florida. A commission investigating the shooting said the design of the school contributed to the chaos and to the number of people killed. It took just 6 minutes to kill 14 students and 3 staff members. Since the shooting, several states have passed school safety initiatives, allocating money for school security measures. But what is most effective? Our correspondent Jessica Gomez reports from Texas, where school architects designed a building with shootings in mind.
Nestled in the middle of a neighborhood in suburban Dallas, George W. Bush Elementary School.
Hola, buenos días, ¿cómo estamos?
The dual language school about to finish its second year. And while it may look like any other elementary school, it was designed to withstand the threat.
Love you, have a good day.
Parents like Autumn Cox fear the most.
You just kiss them and hug them as normal as possible, but in the back of your mind, you are concerned.
Hi.
Principal Maricela Helm feels the pressure every time there's news of a school shooting.
We're going to do everything we can to protect them.
Protection. It's part of why the school was built on a hill with minimal landscaping, so those inside can see who's approaching from the outside.
Good morning.
There's only one entry for guests who have to go through 3 doors as well as a vestibule and the front office before gaining access to the main campus. Their IDs have been scanned, and each visit requires a sign-in.
So you can see from the office all the way down to the cafeteria.
Wide hallways were designed to create more visibility. And the front office, all windows. More than 3 dozen surveillance cameras are always watching.
During a crisis, school administrators can pull up that surveillance footage, but they're not the only ones with access.
Local police officers in their squad cars, as well as dispatch, have a bird's eye view into every school in the district.
I can tell there's individuals coming and going through the front of the school. I can see the hallways. I can see directions that an individual may be moving.
Parents like the Lopez's are on board.
If it means that this is the difference between life and death, right, in a certain situation, bring it on.
People cannot wander through the school blindly.
Texas-based PBK Architects designed the school. They say the Florida school shooting has rekindled districts' demands for safety.
There's not one client right now who comes to us to speak about design considerations that isn't asking this question right now.
PBK increasingly relies on help from local authorities, who say the goal is twofold.
You want to slow down the person with bad intent, and you want to accelerate the first responders' ability to get there quickly.
They're designing schools to be open with more visibility inside and out, keeping public entrances to a minimum, but with multiple levels of security like those vestibules. New and existing schools are also adding bullet-resistant glass and lockdown technology that connects schools like George W. Bush to police.
It makes us feel a little eerie, right? We learned that word, eerie.
Teacher Tanya Wood worries too much security could intimidate her third graders. They're already part of a generation where lockdown drills like this one are the norm.
I hope that we don't see a future that has metal detectors everywhere and security guards walking around with guns. It's a fine line between making sure that students feel safe and keeping them safe.
I love you.
I love you too.
A tough balance for Principal Helm, who says keeping tabs on what's happening with her students is perhaps the most important part of the safety plan.
The closer we are as a community, the more supportive we are of each other, that gives us a huge advantage.
An advantage over fear.
We have a quote in our main office, que tus sueños sean más grandes que tus miedos. May your dreams be bigger than your fears.
High fives.
I want them to dream big. I want them to be ready for school, and I don't want them to be scared.
In Collin County, Texas, for Matter of Fact, I'm Jessica Gomez.
School security spending is a booming industry. Last year, the market for school security equipment reached $2.7 billion, and it's expected to grow.